हेलो चिल्ड्रन, आई एम मिसेस राधा केतकर फ्रॉम डीईएस सेकेंडरी स्कूल पुणे। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट साइंस 1 लेसन 10 स्पेस मिशंस। इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एवरीथिंग, हम्बल बिगिनिंग ऑफ इसरो टू डिफरेंट स्पेस मिशंस, एवरीथिंग वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लोर इन दिस लेसन। सो लेट अस गेट स्टार्टेड। स्पेस मिशंस, द यूनिवर्स इज वास्ट and endless. Human being is always curious about the never-ending expanse of the universe. Billions of galaxies, trillions of stars, deep space, black holes, and many more. Man wants to know more and more about this never-ending universe, and that's why the explorations continue. Many countries are carrying out space missions. These space missions are carried out for various reasons. We are curious about the origin of universe. So, we need to observe various celestial objects, understand them, and to understand our origin. For example, we have 8 planets, other dwarfs, some smaller solar bodies in our solar system. All these objects are bound to each other due to gravity. We always wanted to know more about these objects, carry out space explorations. Our sun is one of the at least billions of stars which are present in the universe. Our Milky Way is just one of the billion galaxies present in the universe. The universe is really vast. The universe contains all the galaxies, stars, and planets. The exact size of the universe is unknown. Scientists believe that the universe is still expanding outwards. Also, we want to know about our neighborhood galaxies. We have such 30 neighborhood galaxies around us. For this study, also various activities are planned. Earth is made up of complex interactive systems. Through satellites, we are able to observe our planet globally using sensitive instruments and to understand the delicate balance among its oceans, air, land, and life. These satellite observations, they are going to help us in studying and predicting weather, drought, pollution, climate change, and many other phenomena that affect the environment, economy, and our society. Now, why these space missions or launching of satellites is necessary? The first reason, communication. Today we are able to communicate with any person on the planet. We can talk, we can share pictures, we can share videos in just few seconds. It does not need even few minutes for a news to spread in the world. What made this advancement possible? The answer is the communication technology. With the help of communication satellites, we could achieve this. Also, to fulfill our urge to understand the universe, many explorations are carried out. These explorations give us knowledge about the origin of universe and also our planet. Third point is navigation. It is the field of study that focuses on the process of monitoring and controlling the movement of a craft or a vehicle from one place to another place. The field of navigation includes 4 general categories. First one is land navigation, second, marine navigation, third one, aeronautic navigation, and fourth one is space navigation. You must have seen cars using navigation to reach the destination. The fourth one is meteorology. It is the scientific study of the atmosphere that focuses on weather processes and forecasting. This weather forecasting is very important for agriculture and it is also useful for fishermen. Now let us discuss how these space explorations started. On 12th April 1961, Yuri Gagarin became the first human to travel in outer space. His flight lasted just for around 2 hours. In this time, he orbited the Earth once in his Vostok 1 spacecraft. Although वोस्टक 1 डिड हैव मैनुअल कंट्रोल्स, इट वाज फ्लोन इन ऑटोमेटिक मोड ऑफ मिशन यू कैन से. Gagarin was selected to undertake this mission for a very interesting reason. He was selected because he was not very tall. His height was just 5 feet 2 inches, which helped him to fit inside that cramped cockpit of the Vostok spacecraft. But there were a few other reasons also. He was very fit, and because he had an outstanding memory, also good reflexes, and he was incredibly focused. These were the reasons he was selected for this mission. Yuri Gagarin was a fighter pilot before becoming the cosmonaut. He died on 27th of March 1968 in a plane crash. On the moon, you will find medals for Yuri Gagarin because he was the first person. He was named as a hero of Soviet Union. Now let us talk about the moon missions. On 20th July 1969, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin became the first two people to step on the moon. When Neil Armstrong put his first step on the moon, he said, "That's one small step for a man, but one giant leap for a mankind." Now let us talk about moon missions. On 20th July 1969, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin became the first two people to step on the moon. When Neil Armstrong put his first step on the moon, he said, "That's one small step for a man, one giant leap for mankind." This was proved true later, as we had so many different missions followed after this moon mission, which gave a new insight for space studies. When we talk about Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin, we cannot forget the valuable contribution of the third crew member. You can see him, Command Module Pilot Michael Collins. When the other two were exploring and collecting samples from the Moon Tranquility Base, that particular area is known as Tranquility Base. This third man kept on orbiting in the dark space alone, waiting for two other astronauts. The mission was possible because of his courage and faith. So we cannot forget the contribution of Michael Collins in this mission. Now let us talk about Kalpana Chawla. Kalpana Chawla was an American astronaut of Indian origin. She was the first woman of Indian origin to go in space. In 2003, Kalpana Chawla was one of the seven crew members who died in the Space Shuttle Columbia disaster when the spacecraft disintegrated during its re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. We all are proud of the contribution which she has made in the field of space missions. There is a very interesting story about Kalpana's childhood. I just wanted to share it with you all. When Kalpana was a little child, she had a nickname called Monto. And they didn't have any formal naming ceremony for Kalpana. When she went to school for her admission, she was asked, "What is your name?" And actually, she did not have any formal name. Her parents said that we have decided three different names, but we have not yet finalized any name. So then the principal asked Kalpana, "What name would you choose?" And she said that, "I will choose Kalpana, that is imagination." And we know she has done a job beyond everyone's imagination. Sunita Williams, she began her astronaut training in 1998. She was launched to International Space Station. She performed EVA, that means extravehicular activity, just on the 8th day of the mission. She has a record on her name for maximum spacewalks by woman. She has logged 29 hours and 17 minutes in 4 spacewalks. She also did break the record of longest single space flight by a woman. She served as mission specialist. She ran the first marathon by any person in space. She completed this distance in 4 hours and 24 minutes. What is International Space Station? The International Space Station is a modular space station. We can call it as habitable artificial satellite in low Earth orbit. We are going to discuss what is low Earth orbit later on. People could live in this artificial satellite and carry out different experiments. So these experiments could be related to astrobiology, astronomy, meteorology, physics, and many other fields. It was a multinational collaborative project. The station served as a microgravity and space environment research-based laboratory in which scientific research was conducted. Now, let us talk about why all these satellites are important. So, if you look around, you will understand all our modern devices, they are based on satellite communication. We need satellites for working of our mobiles. We need it for using internet services. We need it for television. As we discussed before, many decisions related to agriculture, fishery are taken based on the weather conditions. Navigation is also important for transportation and also to locate the necessary devices. Aerial surveillance is very important for security and defense point of view. Satellites can also be used to explore more about soil, fossil reserves, and so many more. So we can say that these satellites are very important for our progress. Let us learn something more about the satellite. An artificial satellite is an object that we have made and launched it into the orbit using rockets. These satellites work for years. They get their power from the sunlight using solar panels. The satellites also have batteries to supply power when the sunlight is blocked by the Earth. Every satellite has a different set of instruments which are installed on it, which are required for its assigned task. These satellites, they are going to orbit the Earth in different orbits depending on their type and their function. So you can see satellites require some main components for their functioning. So what are these components? Let us try to understand. The first one, very important one, is communication system. It includes antenna and transponders. They receive and retransmit the signals. A transponder is a wireless communication, monitoring, or control device that picks up and automatically responds to the incoming signal. The term you can say is a contraction of transmitter and responder. This communication with satellite is very important to receive the valuable information. Then second one is the propulsion system. Artificial satellites are first launched into the desired altitude by conventional liquid or solid propelled rockets. Once they are set in the desired orbit, they use the onboard propulsion system for orbital station keeping. They always need some altitude control so that they correctly point towards the Earth or other astronomical object of interest. Sometimes satellites experience some kind of drag from the thin atmosphere. In this situation, this propulsion system is going to maintain the orbit of that satellite. Then you can see the thrusters, they are fired occasionally to make the adjustments in its position. A satellite's lifespan is determined by the amount of fuel it has to power the thrusters, and later it becomes the part of the space debris. Now let us talk about Sputnik 1. It was the first artificial satellite which was sent into space by Soviet Union in 1957. It completed 1,440 orbits of the Earth. After 21 days, it fell back into Earth's atmosphere. And then followed by Sputnik 2. It was the first satellite which took the first animal to space. The animal was a dog named Laika. The animal had very little space for movement. Laika was alive for some time in space, but later on died due to failure in the cooling system. Now let us discuss about different satellites and launch vehicles. The first one you can see, that is INSAT. So what do you mean by INSAT? INSAT is nothing but the Indian National Satellite System, or INSAT. It is a series of multi-purpose geostationary satellites launched by ISRO to satisfy the telecommunications, broadcasting, meteorology, and search and rescue operations. INSAT satellites provide transponders to serve the television and communication needs of India. Some of the satellites also have the very high resolution radio meter. Sometimes cameras for meteorological imaging, they are also installed. The satellites also incorporate transponders for receiving alert signals for search and rescue missions in the South Asian and Indian Ocean. And the next one is GSAT. The GSAT means geostationary satellite. So these are the satellites, they are made in India. You can say India's indigenously developed communication satellites. GSAT are nothing but geostationary satellites. They are made in India and they are used for digital audio, data and video broadcasting. Then you can see the third category, that is of IRNSS, the Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System. It is an autonomous regional satellite navigation system that is going to provide accurate and real-time positioning and timing services. Then the next one is IRS. India began development of an indigenous Indian remote sensing satellite program to support the national economy in the areas of agriculture, water resources, forestry, ecology, geology, marine fisheries, coastal management, weather forecasting, natural calamities, disaster management, and so on. So now we have studied about these series. Now let us look at launch vehicles, different types of launch vehicles. You can see the first one is GSLV. What do you mean by GSLV? It is nothing but geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle. It is a space launch vehicle designed, developed and operated by Indian Space Research Organization. We know it as ISRO. It is used to launch satellites and other space objects into geosynchronous orbits. GSLV has the capability to carry a heavier payload in the orbit than the polar satellite launch vehicle, that is nothing but PSLV. What is PSLV? Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle. It is India's medium lift launch vehicle. PSLV launched India's first lunar probe Chandrayaan-1. And the most notable achievement, PSLV is Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle. It is India's medium lift launch vehicle. PSLV launched India's first lunar probe Chandrayaan-1. You can say that is the most notable achievement. On 15th February 2017, successfully it deployed 104 satellites in sun-synchronous orbit and it created a record for the highest number of satellites sent in space in a single launch. Now the next chart you can see different types of satellites, what are their functions and the names of Indian satellite series and their launch vehicles. So how these satellites are launched in space. So first one you can see, they are nothing but weather satellites. Okay, we want to know more about weather. Weather forecasting is very important for many different activities which go on. So they will be used for studying and predicting weather. Okay, and which are the satellites? INSAT and GSAT, and they will be launched using GSLV. Then second one you can see, that is nothing but communication satellite. So they are used to establish communication between different locations in the world and they are going to use specific types of waves. So again you can see INSAT and GSAT and launcher is GSLV. Then the third one, broadcast satellite, telecasting different television programs. That will be done using these broadcast satellites, INSAT and GSAT, and launcher is GSLV. Then for navigation purpose, we have navigational satellites. depicts the location of any place on the Earth's surface in terms of its very precise latitude and longitude. So we can get correct location of a particular device using this particular navigation satellite. And we use it extensively nowadays. IRNSS and launcher is PSLV. Then military satellite, you know, we need to get very important information related to defense. Okay, that will be done using these military satellites. They are going to collect all the information which is important for different security reasons and for the defense purpose. Then the last one you can see, Earth observation satellites. Study of forests, desert, ocean, polar ice on the Earth's surface, exploration and management of natural resources, observation and guidance in case of natural calamities like floods or earthquakes. Which are the satellites? IRS and launchers are PSLV. So we can see here different orbits. You can see near the Earth, the red color one, you can see that is the low Earth orbit. Okay, so very close to Earth's surface. Then also you can see the polar orbit. And one more is shown in green color, the bigger one, that is nothing but geostationary one. So different satellites have different orbits according to their function. The satellite is taken to that height using a launcher. That's why this PSLV and GSLV are very important. Then the satellite is given the tangential velocity. What do you mean by tangential velocity? It has to be perpendicular to the radius of that orbit. Okay. And then satellite is then going to start revolving around the Earth, doing its own job. Now, let us understand the formula for this particular critical velocity. You can see what is that critical velocity. We just spoke about the tangential movement, tangential velocity. That is nothing but critical velocity. So you can see here, what is R, the radius of the Earth. Then you can see above that particular radius, on height h, that satellite is going to move. So you can see there, that is the total distance r plus h. Okay, so we are going to derive the formula here. You can understand mass of the satellite is m, height from the Earth is h, centripetal force is given by vc square upon r. It is for mass m, so that's why m vc square upon r. Orbital radius, total radius is nothing but R. Centripetal force is due to gravity of the Earth. Okay, so what is going to pull it towards the center of the Earth? That is nothing but the centripetal force. You must have heard about two words, centripetal and centrifugal. Centrifugal is always away from the center and centripetal is towards the center. Okay, so as we are saying that this is the force which is going to be acting on that satellite. So we can say that it is due to gravity. That's why these forces have to be equal. So we can equate it mvc square upon r is equal to gmm upon r plus h bracket square. Okay, so this you can see small r is nothing but capital R plus h. Okay, so when you take it on the other side, it can be cancelled. So what remains, you can see also the small m is common on left and right side both. So it will be cancelled. So what remains is capital G, capital M upon R plus H. Okay. So what remains is capital G, capital M upon R plus H. Right. But this is VC square. We want VC. So we can take the square root and then you can see we will get the formula VC is equal to under the root sign GM upon R plus H. So what all letters we have used here? You can see capital G. That is nothing but the gravitational constant. We know it is 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Then mass, we know capital M, 6 into 10 raised to 24 kg. Capital R, radius of the Earth, that is given 6400 kilometer. And H is the height of a satellite above Earth's surface. So you can see different orbits here. Low Earth orbit. Highly elliptical orbit, that is the very longer orbit you can see. Also the one which is showing you movement around the poles, so that is polar orbit. And then you can see the geostationary orbit also. In the right hand side picture, you can see something similar to your textbook. LEO, low earth orbit, MEO, medium earth orbit, okay, then highly elliptical orbit, HEO, and then GEO is geostationary earth orbit. Now we have come across two words here. One is geostationary and another one is geosynchronous. Okay, so we are going to discuss it. You can see here, low earth orbit. What is the height? The satellite will be going to a height of 180 to 2000 kilometer from the surface of the earth. What important points you must keep in mind? They are going to complete one revolution in around 90 minutes. So examples are International Space Station and also the Hubble telescope. Then second one you can see, that is nothing but medium earth orbit. The range is going to be from 2000 to 35,780 kilometer. So they are nothing but geostationary satellite. Okay, so geostationary satellite orbit above the equator, and polar orbits are elliptical orbits that we have seen in earlier picture, and they will be completing their revolution in around 2 to 24 hours, so that might vary. Okay, so under this category you're going to have all the GPS satellites, that is nothing but global positioning system satellites. The third orbit you can see, high earth orbit. So the range is going to be from 2000 to 35,780 kilometer. So this is nothing but geosynchronous satellites, and their revolution is going to be in 24 hours. Okay, so satellites for meteorology and telephone signals for TVs and radios will be placed in this orbit, that is nothing but HEO. Okay. So we have started with all the initial concepts of space missions. We are going to continue in the next session. We are going to discuss few more things. Okay, so be with us. Thank you so much. Thank you.